everybody. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm here today just to give you guys a very quick glimpse of how I take down my bonnet in the morning and refresh my hair. I'm on call today at the hospital, so just in case I get called in, let's make this really quick, okay? So what I'm gonna be using in today's video is a little bit of oil, any kind of oil you want. We just want that to moisturize that hand so that we don't cause any frizz. Are my favorite VIP luxury hair grow drops. I love them. Oh my God, and there goes my beeper, so let's make the rest of this very quickly. My handy dandy steamer that everybody knows I'm in love with. Oh, my Senti Global steamer, I love this baby. I've told you guys a million times before, it's my face steamer, but I use it way more for my curls than I do for my face. Okay, now we have to make this really quick because my beeper did go off and I have 30 minutes now to get to the hospital. So, we're gonna pop off the satin cap. And you're gonna see, just like everybody else, I wake up with very flat hair on top. But that's all right, because we're gonna fix that right now. We're gonna pull off our satin scrunchie nice and easily. Shake a little bit to let things fall, and then we're gonna do a little bit of oil, just enough to coat my hands, because I don't like any frizz, and this helps. And then we're just gonna go in there and start to pull things apart, turning on my steamer. So I'm gonna go in with my grow drops. They come in with a nice, convenient little dropper. And I start out at the front, make sure you hold the dropper upright. And I just kind of go in small sections. Then we massage it in with our oiled hands. Massaging my roots and loosening them up a little bit helps to get everything moving, and it helps your hair to flow back into its natural shape. The reason I use the grow drops, which I'm gonna put on the back of my head now too, are because they do just that. They help grow your hair, and they helps to prevent any friction when my hand is in there massaging my scalp. All right, so now you can see I've got a much better shape going. I could clip up the front if I want to, which I do a lot, or I could just leave it down. And like I said, this is day 3 hair from using two of my favorite products, Organigrow Mega Man Grow Milk and the Diva Curl Ultra Defining Gel. These are my 2 go-tos. Now let's get ready to steam. So I just like to hit all the areas of my hair. This is just loosening up. Oh, I see a piece that needs to go. Do you guys do this? Do you see this? All right, let's put the steamer down for a minute. We're going in for some curl control here. All right, guys. So whenever I find, first of all, that end has to go. Can I get? Okay, so first of all, I don't like that end. That end is getting way too thin. So we're gonna go in at an angle. Bye. And I saw there was another one over here that I saw before that. Okay, I think this is it. This is ends that I can tell need to be snipped. That was a damaged end. So let's finish up steaming. So we're just going in, we're letting the steam go through the curls, loosen things up a little bit. And also this is opening the cuticle of your hair. This is why I'm so obsessed with steaming. So I know my big thing is to have a deep conditioner in and to steam, because that opens up the cuticle, allowing the deep conditioner to be absorbed. When you think about it, the best moisturizer is water. So this steam is not only opening up the cuticle, but it's penetrating the cuticle itself. And the steam doesn't actually wet your hair. Your hair is still completely dry. It literally is just opening things up, allowing for some extra moisture to be absorbed. Now for those of you who are transitioning or still have some damaged areas of your hair, I'm going to show you a trick that I use to help refresh those areas of my hair. So sometimes I like to put in a little bit of extra product to those areas and add some moisture, and I'm going to show you exactly how I do that next. This is for my curl friends
who still have damaged areas to their hair that might not be blending very well with the rest of their curls. I have a big patch in the back of my hair that is very damaged, and the curl pattern or lack thereof definitely sticks out from the rest of my hair. So I can feel it already. It's very dry and it looks a lot different than the front of my hair. It's kind of the crown. So it's this section right here. It's this section that I can almost literally grab and separate from the rest of the hair right here. And as you can see, everything underneath looks different, everything to the side looks different, and then there's this. And I hate it. So I'm gonna show you guys how I'm gonna go in and do a quick little refresh to that area. I'm gonna section that area off, and then I'm gonna pull the rest of my hair away from it. So some of these curls, they don't need to be refreshed. They're not part of the damaged area. But this is pretty much what we're gonna take, because I can feel the damage. Just putting a scrunchie around that part just to separate it. And then I can pull everything else back into a separate scrunchie. And I found one. I have 1,000 of these, but whenever I need one, I can't find them. So now I have this one chunk that constantly needs extra attention. And right now it's gonna get that extra attention. It's so dry, so dry. So while trying not to wet the other sections of my hair, I am going to spray down on this one. And we're pretty much just gonna saturate it. So it's relatively wet. So we're gonna get the same two products that we used to do the original wash and go. The Mega Man Grow Milk and the Diva Curl Ultra Defining Gel. So as you can see, I'm just raking that product through just like I typically would. I always use extra product to this section. All right, so the Mega Man Grow is in. Now for the Diva Curl. We're gonna do some praying hands and some smooth. We're gonna scrunch it and hope that this time it's a little less frizzy than the last time, which is why I'm clumping my curls right now, which a lot of you know is very important to me. So as you can see, that whole area is now refreshed with extra product. We're gonna let that section dry. I'm just gonna air dry it. I'm not super concerned with diffusing it unless I'm diffusing my whole head. See how it comes out and blends with the rest of the hair. So when it's fully dry, I'll be back to show you the results. Hey guys, so I'm back from work and my hair has completely air dried. So I'm ready to show you all the results. And this is how everything turned out. So I love the volume that I'm getting. I love that I have more definition now in this area and it blends in a lot better with the rest of the hair. And that was pretty much the goal. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Leave any questions or comments below. Like and subscribe. And take care. Thanks, guys.